Yeah, well, could you first of all introduce yourselves and tell me the name of the organization you represent?
Thank you. I'm Sharmind Neelormi from Bangladesh. I teach economics in a university over there, and I'm associated with Center for Global Change, a research organization.
Okay.
I'm Ahsan uddin Ahmed. I'm a researcher working for Center for Global Change, which is located in Bangladesh. I've been following these negotiations for more than, almost 20 years now. And I also represent, both of us represent GenderCC, a network for a global network for the sake of gender issues and climate change.
I mean, is gender a climate change issue? And if so, how?
Definitely. You see, vulnerability is context specific. So in a given hydrogeophysical location, everybody is not at the same extent of vulnerability. And women specifically, as they have limited access to resources, limited access to public places, especially in our part of the globe, they have limited capacity, you know, to combat climate change, to cope with adversities. So there are issues regarding gender and climate change.
So basically women's voices are simply not being heard. Is that the case?
Women are adapting in a major way. Actually, gender is, just not for women, actually. It's the gendered role and responsibilities in the society. How male and female are, in a different roles and responsibility in society, and how this differentiation makes the, differentiated vulnerability under an adverse situation. That's the whole thematic framework, what we are looking for. Into under climate change discourse.
To just respond to your question, I think it is important to realize that these negotiations have been going on for a while, but very little is actually there in the text, negotiating text, where they have mentioned about gender. There are six mentions in all those pages, in all those paragraphs, and this clearly highlights that gender issues are not really properly heard, and in the negotiations, those concerns are not really addressed properly.
Right. I mean, is it the case that women suffer disproportionately from the effects of climate change when there are catastrophes, disasters?
There are hard evidences. I mean, if you take the, recent experiences in Bangladesh, there was a cyclone 3 years ago, and obviously amongst those who were killed, more than 60% are women, and that clearly demonstrate that how differentiated vulnerability is being faced by women in a given stressful condition, in a given disastrous condition.
And actually not only in the extreme cases, extreme weather events. Even if we consider the climate variability, there are lots of issues regarding gender. For example, food security. All sorts of issues are coming up with gender, actually.
And it comes along with the social construct, the religious taboo and all that. For example, she was talking about food security issues. In Bangladesh, in many of the poor countries, it is the women who, consume the food, the last and the least quality food available for her, because the male counterparts generally take the food earlier and then they enjoy the best what is available in the household. That especially occurs if it is a poor household. So yes, obviously women are particularly vulnerable in those cases. And under stressful condition, women often and in most cases enjoy the, or maybe have the very least which is available there. So there are gender related issues in most of the countries, in especially among the poor families.
So what is it you're calling for here in Cancun? What was the message that you bring to the negotiators?
There are thematic areas, and we have come up with different position papers. Our basic call is integrate gender considerations, not only as vulnerable women not only sketching as vulnerable, as an actor agent of changes as well, to the consider gender in terms of, you know, designing of an activity, in the finance gender should be, you know, accessed, and at the implementation level also, gender should be addressed properly and adequately. This is the basic call in this conference, what we are carrying through.
I think now that the ministers are around and they are deciding for the humanity, obviously, what we would like to express our demand here is that there should be adequate consideration for women, and the gender relationship will have to be respected. And accordingly, the decisions must reflect gender concerns, especially in terms of fast-track financing. The gender issues must be adequately considered in that, and for longer-term finance and also mitigation, because in many of the poor countries, women are actually using energy, which is very low-quality energy, and they're suffering from a number of diseases because of that. And those issues must be considered when they decide for everybody. Everybody, yes, but special consideration must be given for women in her gender-differentiated roles.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Thank you very much.